Politico Politica. Politics for everyone.
Welcome back to Politico Politica with me, your host, Isabella Akinseye. It's time for our Project Nigeria segment. So as the name implies, we see Nigeria as a project. But before going into any project, you want to assess things. We're in 2019. How will you assess the state of affairs in Nigeria?
Well, I think that the state of affairs in Nigeria is really regrettable. I think that it is a shame that a nation that is so blessed as Nigeria, and I always say it this way, I really don't know any nation that is more blessed with mineral resources, natural resources, and human resources as Nigeria is. And yet to see that we have now become the home to the largest number of people living in abject poverty is regrettable.
Now, you've been meeting with the grassroots, you've been going around the country, you've been speaking to people. What would you say is that one big problem across board that Nigerians are facing?
Opportunity. Now, most people may not agree until they start thinking, I say, no, it's jobs, oh no, it's power.
But it is security, education,
yes.
Health.
So now, this is what I'm being. It is the opportunity for everyone to be able to live their dreams, be their best, and create for themselves the kind of life that they would love to live, and to earn a living, to take care of their families, and to be able to live in safety and peace so that they can progress and prosper. All of those things are wrapped up in one thing, opportunity. Why do you think that people are running away from Nigeria? Well, they are running away from Nigeria because of insecurity, yes, for some, because of lack of power for others and all of that. But where are they running to? Are they running to security? Not really. Are they running to power? Not really. That's not what it is. Those things are there. What they are running to when they go across the Libyan desert, what they're running to when they risk their lives across the Mediterranean Sea to get to the other side, what they run into when they leave their jobs and their businesses behind to take their families and go to Canada, to the US, what they are running to is opportunity. So opportunity, I believe, it might sound like a highfalutin thing, is, but you see, everyone deserves an opportunity to be productive. That means you need jobs. And people, Nigerians want jobs. They don't want to be lazy. We are one of the most enterprising people, but Nigerians can't start businesses. 4 out of every 5 businesses started in Nigeria.
So you said opportunity. Yes. So how will you bring opportunities if that's the biggest problem? How do you intend to solve it?
So the first thing that has to happen is that for opportunities to come, you have to make the nation work. The opportunities come when government works for everyone. And that means that there is no one who is marginalized and no one who is deprived of any opportunity in government because of where you come from or who you be or your, how you worship or any of those things. So the first thing that must happen is that government must work for everybody. And there are 4 things that government that will give opportunity to all must offer. Number one, we must be able to reduce the cost of running government. And because there's so much that we are currently wasting in government that should form the kind of investment that we will be making in things that will give opportunity to people. So if you want to give everyone the opportunity to sleep with a full stomach, you invest in agriculture. If you want to give someone the opportunity to be able to sleep with peace, you invest in security. If you want to be able to give people the opportunity to be able to live well and to be able to start businesses and grow their businesses especially, you give them power. If you want, you give them infrastructure. But those investments have been denied us because of the wastage in governance. So the monies we should have used to pay salaries and get people to live well, where, you know, a few people are stealing and carting away in dollars.
So that's the first point, to reduce the cost of governance.
The second thing you've got to reform your government to make sure that there is a culture of delivering service to the people, and not just any service, excellent service. That is the kind of things that people go to look for abroad. They say, you called 911, some guys showed up, and they showed up in, 2 minutes. That is excellent service delivery. We want to be able to make sure that we reform the mind of the civil service to make sure that we are delivering excellent service. The third one is that you've got to restructure the country, especially your economy. And today you see that Nigeria gets literally almost 90% of its earnings from one product, whereas we have mineral resources, metals, stones, all over Nigeria that have not yet been tapped into. We want to release all of that by creating what you would think of as industrial hubs in every local government. That is the vision, that there will come a new Nigeria where every local government, we're going to start first with getting one in each of the 36 states, but then the goal is to see every local government become like Ikeja, like Agbara, where somehow or the other you would have industries and you can connect those industries to by rail to ports so that you can be able to export. And that is going to be the most important thing. To restructure and make that work, you're going to need to think about how do we put money back into the communities where we take those resources from. We are proposing and we're saying when we get into government, a Fela Durotoye and Alliance for New Nigeria-led government will see to resource allocation of 20% to the communities that you get the resources from, 20% to the local government, and 20% to the state. You know, that's 60%, and then the federal government can work with 40%. Currently, the federal government gets 87%, and then the states get 13%, the community doesn't get anything. So we're going to restructure that. And the last one is we're going to reorient our people. You know, we're going to have to go through a values reorientation so that we can build a new mindset of what it is to be Nigerian. We get people to love Nigeria again, get people to give their best to Nigeria and to do their best in this country. That values reorientation will have to be passed through TV, radio, billboards, schools. In our schools, especially in our schools. So we fix values education. And doing those things, we are now able to make sure that we have a healthy and strong, able, productive people who you would love to do business with. And that's how we're going to build a new Nigeria.
So come 2023, what would this new Nigeria look like if Alliance for New Nigeria wins the elections?
I can promise you that come 2023, you will first of all have a nation that people are rushing to go to. The second thing is that we would see that in the next 4 years, there are industrial hubs that have been built and are being built in every local government around Nigeria. Mineral resources, natural resources are being processed, packaged in those areas. So now there are job opportunities in every local government. Nobody has to run to the city to be able to get a job. There will be a lot of construction work going on. We're talking about non-stop construction work. Six-hour shifts, 4 shifts a day, 7 days a week. We will be building roads and building power. We would have captive power, which means we don't have to, first of all, go and put power in the transmission, in our transmission grid. We can generate power for a town and sell the power to the town, you know? So we will see stable power.
What about the issue of security?
It is going to be one of the most important things in Nigeria, and you will see it. You will see Nigerians will have not only a police force of people who are respectable, but also respectful. You would see experts, people who, when you see them, you will be proud to say these are Nigerian police members, because policemen and women, because that is one of the most important things that we have to do. Our army will be strong. And I believe that even then, you will not see or hear of one incident of herdsmen attack, because by in 4 years, we would have ranches and the people would have found out that it is better to ranch your cattle than to be carrying your cattle through other people's property. You know, so we would see
and our girls in captivity.
Oh, by that time, I believe that you know for sure that our girls in captivity will be out, because we would have the political will and the leadership will to go and get them. And we will be able to defeat the army. Today, if you talk to many of the soldiers, today, they will tell you that there are several times that they've gotten close to defeating a group of people and they'll be told to stop and to withdraw. And they say, look, we are just about to take them out. They say, no, withdraw. And they've had instances where some of them actually defied those instructions and engaged and killed some of the terrorists. And then they were court-martialed. So we will have the will to actually do the right thing. We would have a properly equipped force, security agencies, and we will not be able to have all these policemen today that are extorting money from the road. That's not going to be anything. When you see a policeman, you have a sense of security. So in my opinion, in my conclusion, I would say to you that by 2023, every part of Nigeria will be booming with economic opportunities. Every part of Nigeria. We will have people in leadership that are accountable to the people. We will have a nation that understands the values of what it means to be Nigerians. Nigerians will be people that will be proud again that we are a nation.
Thank you, Fela, for your contributions.
Thank you so much.
We'll be taking a quick break on Politico Politica, but don't go anywhere because our lighthearted segment, the quickfire segment, comes up after this break. Join us again.